All right, it's April 22nd, it's a Friday. It's 10:10 a.m. Stay here now. Landlords are here on the property, so. My wife and I have been out here for about 2 hours, roughly. Transplanting the tomatoes. Ouchie-yah! Yeah. And I'm having a great old time trying to bend over and do half of anything. Her on her knees. We got them done. I want to get this video on here real quick just to show you. Everything's out here now. We're going to grow 6 more tomatoes inside from seed. We got enough location. We might do 11 because there's enough out here for 11 more plants. Space for 11 more plants. But we got 6 that we got staked out here. Gotta watch, we got toads all around here. Anyway, we got this one here. Let's zoom out. And then 2. And at the very end down there, 3. Focus. And then off to the side in the back there is 1. So we got 2 back there. We got a couple that are a little too close. We just put one in. We weren't planning on it, but we went ahead and put it in. I think it was this one right here. Because we got 1, 2. We're going to plant one here, but there's a peanut plant right down there. So that would bush out to it. So we moved it from right there in. But then it makes it closer to those two. But see where that upside down cage is. That's a location where we can put another one. Right here. And then it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, there's a spot out here for 7 more tomatoes. But see, I said we could actually put one right there, right before the water right there. So that would be 8. It's 8. Right now, 7. It's 8. Then we could do 9, 10, 11. See, 11 and maybe here 12. No, that's one of the ones I count right. 11, 12 for sure right there. And maybe another one here, so it might be enough space for 13. 6 is, or 7 is what we're going to have. We have set up for right now 7 holes with 7 stakes in them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7 holes out here with 7 stakes. But you can see the tomatoes out here. Transplanted a couple of them, have been transferred a couple times outside here, the wind being so bad. And that's why I went ahead and I just put the plastic around the outer part of the garden. On the west end over there, that's where peanuts are at. There's 4 stakes, tomato stakes over there, about 3/4 of a tomato steak. And I got 3 or 4, I got 4 peanuts down in each hole over there. So, and then I got one here as a wind sock so I can look out my window. I look out that window right there. I sit about, right over in there looking out with my bird food feeders out there. So we got room for 7 right now, and actually we got room for 13, but there's 7 holes cut. 7 more that are cut, but we don't have no more tomato plants. We would have had 3 more, if anything, but those died with the wind. So, yeah, we got coffee grounds. See, that's the thing. We dug down, got them, a couple of them, we've got the bottom branch buried, which they tell you to bury up, the first branch, the first branch, whatever, down. And some of them didn't have any branch, but we buried it deep as we could. Put a little soil, you break up the soil at the very bottom of the hole, you put a teaspoon of, a teaspoon of Epsom salt and sugar. It's 1 cup Epsom salt to 1/2 a cup of sugar. And that's the equation, and then you mix it accordingly, a little bit more, a little less, however you want. And then you put a teaspoon of that down in the bottom, put a little soil on top of that. Then you put your plant, you transplant your plant with the soil from the pot and everything else on top, put it down, and then you put the soil around it. And then we got coffee grounds. We had 2-gallon ice cream containers full of coffee grounds. One of them was quite strong, if you want to say the least. It really made us gag just about what the problem was with that. But anyway, got holes in the top of the lid so that it doesn't mold. But We put that on top. That deters the hornworm and whatnot. And see, we're just going to keep keeping our coffee grounds that way. And as needed, we'll come out here and mound it up. As you can see how it looks on there. It's like a mound up to the tomato plants, on the tomato stem. I try not to touch any leaves. I've got the coffee grounds like a little mound around the plant. See, now that's what a tomato plant should look like right there. That's a good, healthy tomato plant. Watch that one die. See, the wind out here already now is starting to pick up. But you know what? It's the last, Friday of April. So, usually the first week of May is when everybody puts out with this plastic. I should have been able to put this out 4 or 5 weeks ago, which we did. But the wind has just been so damn hectic. That's a Marglobe tomato, by the way. I got a little, shish kebab skew with the label written on it on tape. So I'll know what it is later in the season. There's a few of them that had their that on their little label, so I know what they are. I think that one's a Sioux. But anyway, so we got one, let me count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Now these 16 were grown inside. Last year, the tomatoes I put out that really got so big and they really took off were about that size right there. That's how small they were when I brought them out in the number one garden. That's about it's about 4 inches tall right there. It's very small. That one, all of them in the first row, too. That one, if you can see it, that one. And then that one there, and the one in the, well, actually the two back there, that one's a little bit bigger, but that one there in the back is real small. Now, the wind, you just saw the wind, that's how it should be right there, a little calm with a little breeze here and there, and maybe a gust once in a while. But before it was just constant, 10 miles an hour or stronger. And then add a wind gust to that, you know, they're telling you it's like, it says 6 miles an hour with wind gusts of 22. I'm thinking, well, it's more like 18 miles an hour, wind gusts of around 30. Because we're out in the open here. 300 acres of Monsanto cotton is going to be around us now. So, I'm starting to prep the fields. That's the only bad side. The beans start coming up. Walk over this way. Gosh. If I can walk. I'm not sure, but I believe that is a bean right there. No, I don't think I have any planter. But that thing in the top, middle, almost looks like a plant of some sort. I don't know. I don't think I planted. This has got, I think, black-eyed peas in. Let me back out. That whole two black-eyed peas. Two black-eyed peas in that one. Two in that one. Bush bean. Flora bean rather. I got two down there. Don't know which ones I have down here either anymore. Like I said, I got them on the previous video from this one. There. I got two down there, one in there. Then on this cinder block, that's why I have the cinder blocks out here too. So I had a cut on this side. I got two in it. I got two in that one. And two in that one. And these are the original beans I had planted. The second set of beans I planted down here. Here we already have a bean growing. I wish I could remember. Like I said, they're on previous videos. I just know these are the big ones about the size of a quarter. One is white, one of them is like a purplish white marble looking. That one there, and that one right there. These are the ones we got built fence for. I did it for these others, but what I did for the back over there, zoom out. I got a little toe down here, I don't want to squish me, it's under the plastic. But see, I got these little leads here first, it's about 21 inches. And I was going to tie string to go to the back, and then that's 6 feet roughly, and we got four of those. So we got four 21 inch leads coming out of this starter hole with a string or something, or if they get long enough to go attach onto them and then go on. This one here, I just got a lead right there, a lead here, a lead here. I could use this one, this lead right here that's laid over, for this one here that's coming up. All I have to do is take that tomato stake up and put these two down and then use them in the back, because I got another one, two right back here. I hope these frogs get in the mud. I call them frogs. Toads and frogs aren't that the same thing, but to me they are. It's like a bass and a salmon. They're both fish, right? So anyway, I put the same there and plant one here. Again, now the seeds I've gotten from Heirloom Solutions, I put one seed down, one plant comes up. If I put two seeds down, two plants are gonna come up. That's why I didn't plant two. But then again, look, I did there. You see there's two coming up. Where's it? Oh, I'm in the water right there. You see two beans coming up. So we definitely gotta get those fences made up. At least one, two, three, four. I gotta do four more 6 foot fences. There are three beans up in the front here growing, so that's three. And then this one here, it's not growing yet, but I could go ahead and get that one made up and have it ready. But see in the back here, I planted from those last four over here, I planted, oh look, I didn't see that before. See that one right there? I hear helicopters. Military? I'm not gonna get it. He's on the top of the trees, he's going over there. You can barely see him. He's just now behind the trees. Anyway, got one here. See, this right here and the ones up front are the same. So, I planted four back here. One, two, three, four, yeah. Let me get over here, gosh. See, I'm getting myself confused. I'm right on top of it, so it's kind of like making me get off balance here about what I got where. Yeah. Oh, see, I got a fence for that too, though. That one there. Right down there. Right there. See? That's about 22 inches, 24 inches from this one here to go back. And after that, we still got more tomato stakes and we do have a little more fencing. Get a 50-foot roll, 3 foot high, and cut it in half, and then you got 100 feet, 18 inches, which is all you need, really. And I'm killing myself bending up the bottom on one half of this. The fencing, you're gonna have the little barbs down there, and the other half's gonna be like this right here, and then the other half is gonna be with those hanging down, and I bent them all up on those little leads up there. But I got tired of doing that, so I just left them on these long ones, just let them sit down, ain't gonna hurt nothing. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 more fences, 6 foot fences roughly. I got the tomato stakes and I got the fencing around by the tree up there. It should be enough. But again, it's like $28 for a 50 foot row, 50 by 3 foot row. You cut that in half, you got 18 inches by 100 feet. So, the beans are coming up over here. The tomatoes have been transplanted finally. I'm gonna start more tomatoes in the house, at least 6. Could do 13. When we till all this up, like in the previous videos, we planted marigolds around this garden. And I've started putting marigolds around different areas too. I've different sporadic flowers all around the gardens now. I don't want to walk in the mud right now barefoot. I'm not like that dog right there, Petey. Right where he's at is where onions were planted, but like I said, it was flooded out here a couple times, heavy rain, washed it all up. There's a sunflower growing right there. See, there's so many seeds that dropped off everywhere right there, there's a sunflower. Petey, get off there, buddy. There's corn where he's at. Get off there. Come on, get off there. And then we got the garlic up there. We got 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 of them. 13. It should have been 6, the long ones, and we planted 6 and 6, but again, with the rain, it almost worked. Well, no, they were bulbs, as a matter of fact, and knocked them over. There was one that was knocked over, that last one that looks kind of yellow. It was knocked over. Let me see if I can get on it right there. The yellow, it was under soil, and I just happened to see the bulb a little bit, and I dug it up. I didn't want to dig up the roots, so I dug it, and that's where that was. Now I got standing up trying to prop it up. It should grow just like those others right there. Those will be ready in about the third week of June, second week of June maybe. Cucumber, the traditional green, which is black beauty oak zucchini. Then we have 6 golden zucchini, and then I have a pumpkin, one pumpkin, because the pumpkin was over there last year. Took off. We have a total of 12 corn plants, 6 of 2 different packs, both sweet corn, but 2 different packs. 6 on the back, right there, right on the edge, and then the 6 right here. And then, within the last week. In 2 weeks, then I'm going to plant 6 more away from them right there, and then 6 away up here, and then we'll do another 6 and 6. So we'll do 12 in 2 weeks from now, 12 more, and then after that 12 more, so 36 all total, just 2 week intervals or 3 week intervals. So it'll be, that one's a week, so we'll do 2 more weeks, it'll be 3 weeks, and then when those are planted, 3 weeks from that, and then 3 weeks, and then we got okra over here. So, and it's all from seed, like I said, nothing is bought from the store, brought home and planted out here. Did that last year, and they were okay, but we also had we had an infestation with hornworms. That's why we're taking the precautions with the coffee grounds around the plants now too. I'm gonna keep that maintained. So just like I say, all the dirt that's around the edges of this plastic now, we planted seeds and all different flowers, so all medicinal type flowers. Marigolds, if you get the real good marigolds, like from a respectable heirloom place, they'll keep mosquitoes away. They help keep mosquitoes away. But the stuff you buy nowadays is so Monsanto screwed up. See, this is my sunflower fence is going to be around here. I don't know, these may be thinned out slightly, but not much. But they'll get thinned out. Gonna mow the lawn now that Mr. Thomas makes us look bad now.